My name is Chelsea. I am a second year medical student here at St. George's University. It's about 5 a.m. I am headed to campus to get some studying in before I have some obligations. And this is just a day in my life. Hey guys, so this is kind of an atypical day for me. I have two big tests coming up next week. So today consists of a lot of studying. I'll get a workout in and I'll practice for my OSCE tomorrow. So like some physical exam stuff with some friends later today. So I just finished studying and I'm grabbing a quick bite of breakfast before I head off to my IMCQs. My IMCQs are basically, we go answer a bunch of multiple choice questions and our professor's there to basically explain why the answer is right or why the answer is wrong and kind of walk us through how we should have gotten to the right answer. Okay, so a lot of people want to know like why St. George's and why the Caribbean. I didn't get into American medical school and my cousin went here and she said, well, Chelsea, do you want to be a doctor? And I said, yes. And she said, okay, well then go to St. George. And, but I picked St. George specifically over the other Caribbean medical schools because it's accredited. I have a much better chance of matching in terms of residency. They do have a really good match rate. They also have a very good pass rate on their step. But beyond that, I would say the most important factor is that they are very well internationally connected. And I think that's really important. I personally want to do some international medicine and they're connected everywhere from Kenya to Thailand to the UK to India. I think that's really incredible. I think that's a really incredible opportunity for a medical student as well as anybody who wants to work in international medicine or advance their career internationally. It's a really incredible perk here at St. George's. So I just got out of IMCQs. Basically, the whole point of that is to ensure that we know the material for the test and that we're kind of paying attention to the details. It's a good place that we can kind of like see where our weak spots are. And like maybe if you misunderstood something in lecture, it's a really good place for you to find that out before the test. And right now I'm gonna go get a workout. I try to work out every day. But yeah, that's kind of where I'm at right now. So I just finished my workout. I really try to work out every day, like 5 or 6 days a week, because I think that it's more than just physical health. It's a lot of mental health too. It's kind of like my hour every day that I can disconnect from studying, from people. Like I just turn on my music and I just let my brain relax. It's really helped with like stress management in medical school. It's also just helped kind of like my mental health in general. And so it's something that I make a priority every single day. Hey, So I just kind of wanted to address some things. I know there's like a lot of misconceptions about Caribbean schools versus American schools, and like what it really is like in a Caribbean school and what are the pros and the cons. In general, I think that no matter where you are and no matter where you're in your life, there will be good things and there will be bad things. And it's all about how you address those things and how you kind of proceed with the cards that you were dealt. And so as far as medical school in the Caribbean goes, at the end of the day, you're going to become a doctor. You're going to get what you've been working for the whole time. I think that that's the end goal. Beyond that, there will be opportunities here that you won't get anywhere else. I've been given the opportunity, and it's been incredible, to be immersed in a culture that's not my own. I've been able to learn from these people, and it's been really beautiful. Now, that doesn't address the cons. So I would say that the cons are that it's really hard to live in another culture. It's very hard to be 3,000 miles away from everything you know. I would also say that in terms of resources and in terms of academic opportunity, you have to fight for your own. You have to be a self-learner and you have to be a self-advocate for your own education. And so I think that if you're ready to do that, then a Caribbean school is definitely a choice that should be on your plate when you're considering whether or not you'd like to be a physician. So as far as matching goes and pass rates on your step, so matching is going to be more difficult at the end of the day. So we have a 94% match rate. I think the thing about that statistic is it doesn't show a lot of people who are interested in coming. Where those people are matching. A lot of people are matching in things like internal med, OBG, gyn, and family medicine. And if that's something you're really passionate about, then obviously that won't be an issue for you. For anybody who's maybe a little more wanting to go towards like a surgical route or a neuro route, it will be more difficult. And so when you are looking at a competitive specialty, you really need to go above and beyond to ensure your spot. So I'm not saying it's impossible because it certainly is not. We have plenty of grads in competitive specialties. I know them, but they had to work extra hard to get there. So I just like, I'm just out here enjoying my break, eating some lunch, looking at this stunning ocean in front of me. I just want to talk about some things that kind of happen to medical students. So depression and kind of anxiety kind of riddle medical students quite often. And I just wanted to say, like, to anybody who feels like they're struggling, or maybe they don't feel okay right now, like, reach out, you know, and take a deep breath and ask yourself, like, okay, how am I doing? Check in with yourself all the time and kind of proceed based on how you're feeling. But just make sure you always reach out because it can make a really big difference. Yeah, so what I'm doing right now is I'm doing percussion, and we percuss the lung fields to test for dullness to percussion or hyperresonance. Basically, it's going to tell us if there's fluid in the lungs or maybe some gunk like from a pneumonia or air, so something like a pneumothorax. So I just finished practicing my OSCE, but now my night's not over. I'm gonna go run an exam review for a term below me, term three. So yeah, I'll be teaching until about 9 or 9:30 tonight. So that was pretty much my day. Kind of got up, I did some studying. From studying, I went to my IMCQs, and then from my IMCQs, I got some more studying and a workout in. I got some OSCE practice, and then I ran an exam review. This isn't the most typical day, but time frame wise, it's definitely what I do. I normally get up at 4:30 and I'm usually home by about 10. And then wake up, rinse, lather, and repeat. So I just really want to thank you for watching me today and kind of seeing what my life is. For anybody who's trying to get into medical school, just keep working. Just keep going. You're going to get there. And no matter what path you take, you're going to end up being a doctor, and it's all going to be worth it in the end. For anybody who has any questions or wants to follow me or see my journey, you can follow me on Instagram at cspence10. But yeah, thanks so much for tuning in.